Water, something we easily take for granted when life itself would be impossible without it. To mark the special day dedicated to H2O, our Oh Soo-young met with some innovative minds working to ensure a water-secure future for generations to come.
Korea is running short on water. The average citizen uses about 282 liters of water a day, 40% more than the global average. And on top of that, leaky old pipes waste around 650 million tons of water every year. The water shortage is expected to get significantly worse by 2025, especially with Korea's limited rainfall that's concentrated in the summer, along with the dry spell seen in recent years. That makes it all the more important for the country to save as much as it can by harvesting rainwater. According to Professor Han Moo-young at Seoul National University, it's something that can be done in a way that's not much harder than sitting in his rooftop garden run entirely on rainwater.
All water comes from precipitation, but we let it go to waste, down the drains and into the river, which is why we're so short of water. If we collect water from the surface instead, that could help overcome shortage and reduce energy usage at the same time.
A storage tank collects the raindrops that glide off the roof and the edges of the building, and it can even be extended into a water feature or a pond. Potted plants and flowers of your choice can also absorb the rain, which seeps through the roots and into the pipes before it's filtered for use. In fact, the water is so clean that it can be used to grow fresh produce. A local farming cooperative supported by the district has set up an organic vegetable farm on the rooftop.
This green space not only refreshes the mind, but also tackles the water shortage, drought and overheating. It's very breezy here in the summer. The raindrops fall into the storage tank, and if it wasn't here, the drains could flood when there's heavy rain. So the storage tank allows a smaller amount of water to flow into the drain, preventing floods. By growing crops, we also enhance food security. So it's a multi-purpose system in a way.
Another way to procure more water through the gift of nature. A research team at Pohang University of Science and Technology has invented a process of desalinating seawater, based on the roots of the tropical mangrove plant.
Through a microscopic test, we can analyze the structure of the mangrove's roots and see where it filters out the sodium. We do that by injecting a fluorescent substance that is sensitive to sodium ion. After some time, we compare images to see where the sodium shows up.
The layered structure of the mangrove roots naturally filters out saline material, and the team has developed a layered membrane filter that emulates that chemical process.
Desalinization plants are huge and require large amounts of pressure and electricity. Such facilities also require regular and costly maintenance and repair work, because the salt builds up and can hurt its performance. But our technology takes advantage of gravity. We think using our technology can drive down facility costs to a fifth or a tenth. And, because it requires no electricity, those costs can be reduced too. In terms of performance, it could outdo conventional technologies.
Not only is the membrane solution compact and energy efficient, it could one day be used to make straws or plastic bottles that would enable you to drink straight from the ocean. It's not just a handy piece of technology, it's a groundbreaking development that could resolve the water shortage problem, not only in Korea, but across the world.
About a third of the world is water poor, and that will rise to 50% in the near future. As quality of life improves, high-quality drinkable water becomes scarcer. So we are looking at the drinking water market. The technology could be especially useful in countries like Indonesia, India, and Pakistan, because it can be used in contaminated water.
The team's findings were published in the journal Nature and by the American Chemical Society. Professor Lee's team is currently working to optimize the technology for wider use. With innovative and affordable technology powered by the elements of nature, Korea's experts are striving to make every droplet count towards a water-secure future. Oh Soo-young, Arirang News.